Inside the Magic, covering Walt Disney World, Disneyland, Universal Studios, and more.
Remember Dr. Facilier, right? His daughter Celia will be joining the cast of Descendants 3. It's gonna get a little scary. Make some noise. It's Jada Marie! Yes! Welcome! Welcome, welcome! Now another new addition to the D3 cast, and it might be the evilest villain yet, and that is saying a lot, complete with blue hair and rocking an electric guitar. Y'all give it up for Hades himself, Cheyenne Jackson! Hey, there he is! Next up, she's rotten to the core, you guys know her. She is Evie, daughter of the Evil Queen. Show some love for Sophia Carson! Welcome, Sophia. And finally, no one rocks purple hair quite like her, the daughter of Maleficent. Please give a FanFest welcome to Dove Cameron. Here we go, the cast of Descendants 3. You guys, give it up. Amazing to see all you guys here. Welcome to FanFest.
Thank you.
Some of you returning, some of you it's brand new. How's your experience been here so far?
Amazing.
Yeah?
First surreal.
First time here? Okay, what's the impression? You got to meet some fans and hang out a little bit?
Yes, they're amazing.
Yes? How about you guys?
It's so incredible. I mean, this is one of our favorite days of the year when we get to meet you guys, see you, hug you, see how much you love the movie like we do. It really means the world, and we couldn't be having a better day.
Well, we are so excited to have you. We've been waiting all day long for this this amazing time to have you guys all out on stage. I know you guys have so much going on as well. Sophia, tell us what you've been up to. I know we got a freeform show, we got to talk Arties,
sure.
And of course, Descendants 3.
Yeah,
what's going
absolutely.
On, girl?
Absolutely. Well, we have Descendants 3 coming out this summer. Who's pumped for that?
Uh-huh.
Yes, I'm also in a show called Pretty Little Liars, a Perfectionist. Which has been airing on Freeform right now, which is so exciting. And yeah, I'll be the host of the Arties this year, June 16th, live for the first time.
We're excited.
Yeah, we're really excited about that. And also working on some new music.
There we go. All right. Yeah. Very nice. And I heard you're part of a new Disney Channel project called Fastlane. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, Fastlane was so much fun. It was filmed in Vancouver, which is where I'm from, so it was amazing to be at home. And I made friends with the whole cast. It was a blast. I'm so happy that everyone got to see it because it came out a few months ago.
I love it. Jada,
yes.
What was it like joining this amazing cast? How has this been?
A dream come true. Literally, I looked up to Dove and Sophia I've looked up to them for a while, literally since D1. So I'm kind of... We love you. Yeah, it's really amazing. They're the sweetest people I've ever met in my whole life, and they're super funny, and I just love every moment with them.
And tell us a little bit about Celia and kind of what she's bringing to the Isle of the Lost in D3.
Well, Celia is a little mischievous little thing.
Uh-huh, I heard something about that.
She's a daddy's girl, and she's just all about the cash, like her dad, so, yeah.
All right, we can't wait to see it.
Thank you.
Stage legend Cheyenne Jackson, welcome.
Hello.
Now, how fun is it to play a bad guy? I just gotta ask you that.
It's the most fun to play the bad guy. I don't think he's that bad, but no, it's my kids. I have 2-year-old twins, and they came to and watched me on set, and I have giant blue hair, and they call me Daddy Blue Hair. It's very fun. Very fun.
I love it. Dove, what's it like reuniting with the cast for this amazing movie?
Oh, it's phenomenal. I mean, I think that everybody's, you know, when you say we're all like a family, people are a bit skeptical to believe it, but really we're like a family at this point. You know, we've been together for 5 years, a little bit over that, and we're so close, we're so in love, and it's just magical to be able to be together not only for the movies, but for special days like this.
Absolutely, and the fans are so excited to see you guys as well. Some familiar faces, some new faces, we love it all. And speaking of some new evil faces, we have an exclusive trailer featuring Hades himself. Are you ready for this? A FanFest exclusive. You guys are the first to see this. Let's check this out, featuring Mr. Cheyenne Jackson himself.
Woo! Auradon under attack. My, oh my, that sounds terrible. My heart goes out to them, truly. It's hard to imagine who would possibly want to harm them. It's not like Beast and Belle decided long ago to cast out those who didn't fit the Auradon what's right or wrong, forcing everyone who disagreed with them away to a crowded little island with no magic, no freedom, no hope. There's only so long you can be here before it drives you to madness. It makes you think, is every person here really evil? Do they deserve to be here? I was Lord of the Underworld, not Lord of the Underground. I didn't want their world when they imprisoned me here, but after being caged up for years, maybe I do want to take everything from them. That's why I've been watching, waiting, planning for the precise moment to act, because the people of Auradon have long since forgotten how close they are to the threat they created. My time here is over, and all that stands in my way is a foolish prince and a handful of VKs who have turned their backs on their own people. Oh, Auradon, were you so arrogant to think if you wrong us, we shall not seek revenge?
I got chills. Sean, how do you feel when you watch that?
That's the first time I've seen it.
How is that?
It was good. He looks nice and scary.
Yeah. How did you kind of get into that place before getting into this character? I mean,
I purposely didn't watch the movie because I didn't want to do anything that James Woods did. So the brilliant Kenny Ortega, our director.
Love you, Kenny!
Yes.
Kenny!
I had an idea how I wanted to play this character, and he had an idea, and we kind of went into a rehearsal studio, turned on some music, and Kenny was like, let's just dance. And we like got into it, created this character, and I just wanted to create something fun that my kids could watch, and this is really great to join this family, so thank you.
We love you, Shai.
And what's this moment like to you guys as a cast? I mean, you guys have been working on this movie for so long. There's, you know, you get the script and you go and shoot it, and then you have to stay secret for so long. Now things are finally being able to come out. You get to show exclusive clips to the fans. How is this now? Is this the fun part for you guys being able
it's
to just enjoy this?
Yeah, it's the we were saying it's the first time we've been together really as a full cast since we wrapped D3.
Yeah.
And it kind of kicks off our summer of promo. Till everyone gets to see D3, which is unreal. So yeah. For us, it's so magical to be together, to be sharing in this with all of you. We wouldn't be here without you guys. You really are everything. So thank you for magical moments like this.
Absolutely. And is there any other exclusives maybe we could
Yeah, I think
here?
There's something else that we can show, right, Shai? I heard that there's something that we can show.
And there might be. Maybe. You guys want to see one more thing?
Only if you want to.
I don't know. Are you guys ready? Should we get a drum roll or something? Yeah, drum roll, please. Okay,
all right,
go.
Let's roll.
They're asleep. All of Auradon is in danger.
All of the scepter and the queen's crown have been stolen.
A sleeping spell spreads throughout Auradon. We're trying to discover which villain has perpetrated this evil.
I know how villains think. We are very short on time. A great evil will have their revenge. And all in Auradon will pay forever.
Every time we open the barrier, we're exposed to danger.
He was draining all my magic, but I felt my power slipping away.
The only thing more powerful than the scepter is Hades' Ember.
Yeah!
Unless I get that Ember, it's game over.
Descendants 3 coming this August. Okay. That is the FanFest exclusive right there. You guys are the first to hear that is coming in August. Descendants 3. Absolutely amazing. You guys, congratulations on everything.
Thank you so much. Thank
now, before we let you go, we do have a few fan questions that were submitted, okay? Today is FanFest after all. So, what are some of your favorite memories from filming the Descendants movies?
There are so many.
So many.
I feel like one of my favorite memories is one that we actually just made in this third film.
Yeah.
Sophia and I keep talking about it, but on our very last day of shooting our last musical number, which actually was coincidental, because usually when you shoot a movie, you shoot out of order. We coincidentally shot the finale on our last day.
Yeah, and it was something really emotional to all of us, because we all love the musical number so much.
Yeah.
And we
didn't want it to end, and so we stayed.
We stayed, we just laid on the ground of the set of this massive green screen until we basically were told that we had to leave.
Until the crew picked us out.
We cried, we laughed, we reminisced.
Took a lot of photos.
These last 4 years have been, and it was really magical.
Yeah.
How do you guys usually spend your free time on set? I know you guys are buds, it's a family, but
no,
when you do get to, do you get free time on set, or is it go, go, go?
Oh wait.
The one night we all went to the one hotel room and went to the grocery store and got a whole bunch of snacks.
Yeah. That was the night that we wrapped. We went in our robes still. I think we all had our robes on that we took from set, and we went grocery shopping.
We got all
the snacks.
The food that we wanted so badly, all the ice cream and the bread and all the things that sounded so comforting, and then we just went to one room and we ate it all
everything.
In one night. And just cried.
It was great.
It's imagine as silly as it sounds.
Imagine being in that grocery store, like, was that the Cast of Descendants in robes?
Like 12 of us.
We had space buns.
Yeah, I think it was.
Robes on. It was great.
We have another fan question. Do you have a favorite scene that you filmed for this new movie? Favorite scene? Maybe for all of you, just
the musical numbers are always
the musical
favorite.
Numbers.
Yeah, those are always the highlight.
I know it's harsh, you can't give away too much, but.
Yes.
Do you have some favorite scenes, right?
One of mine was something I did with involving Hades that we can't reveal, but that was definitely one of my favorites.
I agree.
Yeah, mine too. And there was one number that I wasn't in. It was a massive dance number, but I was standing behind Kenny Ortega and the whole, and there must have been 100 dancers and on every tier, and it was watching him orchestrate all of this.
Wow.
It was massive, and I think the biggest number that they've ever shot. It was mind-blowing for me. I mean, I'm usually on American Horror Story covered in blood and the
Yes!
A new thing. So it's really fun.
And that's why Kenny's the man, because he can do stuff like that, right?
Exactly.
Another fan question, if you could trade places with another character, play any other character other than yours, who would it be?
I don't know, I love Evie.
Yeah, I love Mal. I feel like I'd want to play a guy.
Yeah.
Maybe like Boo Boo? Or Hades. Or Harry.
Someone
or Harry
is always fun.
Yeah.
Uma.
I'd want to be Uma.
Uma.
Yeah.
Uma's
fun.
Uma.
I was
really fun.
And the whole audience is like, yes.
Uma.
And did you guys have a favorite DCOM growing up? Disney Channel original movie. Another fan wants to know your favorite DCOM growing up.
I think High School Musical.
High School Musical, for sure.
Right?
I think Brink.
Brink!
Oh, I'm so happy somebody said Brink.
Classic.
I always say that and I get weird looks. That's a great movie. What about you guys? Some favorite DCOMs?
High School Musical.
Okay.
High School Musical 2, 3, 1, all of them.
Love it. Love it all. All right, well, we do have one more exciting thing to share today, right? We're full of excitement, you guys. It's FanFest. That's what it's all about. All right. So, coming this September, the Descendants Party is coming to Disney California Adventure Park. It is a mega VK party just in time for Halloween, and we know you guys are excited, so we have an exclusive first look at that just for you guys. Check this out. Here we go. All right, so we got a teaser so far, okay? So it's going to be called the Descendants Party. You guys are going to be able to come in here, hang out, learn dance moves from DJs. They're going to be spinning your favorite music from Descendants. It's going to be part of the Oogie Boogie Bash Disney Halloween Party featuring Descendants. So how do you guys feel about
that? We're kind of freaking out about that. We're going to be in the Disney parks? Like, that's crazy!
Right?
Oh,
way crazy.
Like, when you guys came on set for the first day of Descendants 1, all the way until now, everything it's become. I mean, this must just be surreal for you guys.
It is. It's magical.
Absolutely. I mean, I think to be a part of the parks in any way feels like, you know, the Disney parks.
Yeah.
What more magical place is there?
Absolutely.
So to feel like you're a part of it is something so surreal.
So thank you guys.
Yeah, thank you so much.
You're seeing a little preview of what you can expect from that. The Descendants Party, it is coming, you guys. We are so excited. Descendants 3 is on the way. Make some noise for the cast of Descendants 3, everybody! And we are going to end this fan fest with our very own Descendants Party. So we're going to roll some music that you guys know. Get up, dance, sing along if you know the words. We are going to bring up all of our favorite Disney Channel talent as well. You're not off the hook yet, guys, okay? You guys are coming up here. We are going to dance. Let's cue the music and end this fan fest the right way, you guys. Make some noise. Let's go!
Hey, 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 hey patient. We're gonna steal the show and leave them all defenseless. To the core, rotten to the core. I'm rotten to the core. We could ask for more. I'm nothing like the kid next door. I'm rotten to the core.